Hello, I'm Ilian Saint-Hilaire, and in this video, we're going to talk about Mesh Central static sites and user redirection. Mesh Central, of course, is a big website for remotely managing computers, but it can also be used as a web server for static websites. And that can be useful for a whole bunch of stuff. And it makes it easy for you to combine your static sites and Mesh Central without having to use reverse proxies or other things like that. So let's take a look at how we can make this happen. So first, I have my trusty developer server on the upper left here. This is the web page for it. I can, of course, click on a machine, connect to it, and it works perfectly. Okay, so now that I've set up my basic Mesh Central server, you'll notice that if I go to meshcentral.com, you will notice that there is this static website with branding and so on and so forth, and there's this button to log in to the public server. Now, you would think that what I've done is I've taken a reverse proxy, and when you go to meshcentral.com/info, maybe I have this separate Apache server or something. And then when you click on login here, I redirect you to the Mesh Central server. But actually, the Mesh Central server is serving this static web page. So it makes it super easy, and I want to show you how you can do this yourself. So, what I'm going to do is show you, first of all, the config.json of my server right here. So I have a very simple one. I have a simple server name. I'm using MongoDB. And I have, in this case, two domains. I have the default domain and a second domain called devtest. And then let's encrypt is not being used. So that's why there's the underscore here. So if I go to Mesh Central, my DNS/devtest, then I have my second domain here. And because I'm running user admin in my parameter there, I'm always logged in. I don't need to look at the login screen. So that's why it's always like that. And you'll see here dev box with test. That is the title of that domain right there that shows up on the top. Okay, so one thing that's pretty amazing is, and that's not very known, is that you can create a domain. So for example, I'm going to create an info domain, and that domain is going to have this share key that's going to point to a folder where you want to have a static site. So now this domain is not a meshcentral.com domain. It's actually just a static website with a folder where to share the pages. So I'm going to open File Explorer here. I'm going to create a new folder. I'm going to call it info site, information site. There we go. And you'll notice that my share here goes to C drive info site. So that's how I have it there. And then I am going to create a new text document. I'm going to call it index.html. So that's going to be my first page. Actually, that's the default first page for this static website configuration. So good. I'm going to go and open that up. I'm going to say hello. That's it. Nothing else. And so now I didn't restart the server yet, but I'm going to go ahead and restart the server. This will make it the configuration effective. And of course, if I go back to the root folder, I get Mesh Central. But if I go dash info, enter, I see hello. And that's because the info domain points to this site, and I see hello right there. Okay, now what if I want to create, just like on meshcentral.com, I have this button here to log in, you know, to redirect users to the login page. Well, what do I do? Well, first of all, I'm going to rerun the server without auto login. So I'm just going to run it like that. And then the other thing I'm going to do is go to the web page. And I'm going to create a href. And oh, actually, well, what I can do is show you. If I just go to slash login, it will go to the login page. So all I need to do is on this website have a link that goes to slash login, and that's it. So href equals slash login, login Perfect. And so now I can hit refresh. You'll see the login button. And when I click on it, shows the login page. So basically, you can have a nice fancy website here. It's all static, of course, but you can have pictures and style sheets and multiple HTMLs and so on and so forth. And when you click login, you go to the login page. So this allows you to basically create a front page for your service, maybe instructions on, you know, what your service is for and so on. And then when you click, when a user wants to log in to create a new account or to log into the service, they do that there. Okay, now if I go to just the root folder, I go to the login page. But if I do slash info, of course, I go to the second domain, the info domain. But what if I want to have people, let's suppose I want to have it so that everybody who goes to the root folder of this website actually is redirected straight to the information page. So what we're going to do is I'm going to have this thing called root redirect. I am going to add to the default domain this key that says root redirect. So whenever somebody runs, hits the root folder, redirect to this address right here. So I'm going to save it, restart the server. And I need to restart the server because, of course, it's a config change here. And then when I hit reload there, what happens is that I get redirected to the information site directly. So as soon as you hit the root, boom, you get redirected there. And of course, if you hit login, you go to the login page. So this is actually how meshcentral.com is configured. It's super easy. I just added an info domain, put the folder here, and put a root redirect. Now, in some cases, what you would like to do is that if a user is already logged in, so I'm going to log in here. Oh, actually, that was the wrong password. Let's see. Oh, well. I need to, what I'm going to do here is I am going to log in. I'm going to fix my password because I forgot what it is. Terrible me. So I'm going to go into the login page. Oops. There you go. And I'm going to change my password. Admin. Okay, perfect. Now I'm going to log out again. And let's see if I can log in using, there it goes. So admin. This is, of course, just for debugging. Perfect. Got failed attempts here. Okay, so now what I want to do is, see, when I log out, when I hit logged out, I go to the root page, and the root page, of course, redirects me to the info page. Now, what if I want to make it so that if somebody lands on the root page, but it's a known logged in user, go into Mesh Central. But if it's not a known logged in user, then redirect to a certain page. So there's this thing called unknown user root redirect. So you use that instead. And so this will make it so that if you land on the root and you're already logged in, you'll see the Mesh Central devices page. If you're not, you'll be redirected. So let's restart the server and try that. There we go. And so, there it goes. So now I'm going to go straight to the root, and I'm redirected to this static page. Now I'm going to log in. Okay, so now I'm logged in. Now I'm going to go back and just hit the root again. And I'm going to go straight into the devices page. Now this is especially useful if you have SAML or OAuth domain authentication. So maybe what you want to do is, if a user is not logged in and they land on the root folder, your root URI, what you want to do is redirect them to your corporate login page. And as soon as they log in there, then they get redirected back and it works. But otherwise, if they're not logged in, if they're already logged in, then, like, for example, I'm right here and I want to hit refresh. I'm already logged in. I don't need to see get redirected again. So that is pretty good. Last thing I want to show is, I'm not going to demo this too much, but there's another one called, actually, I could demo it, called IP blocked user redirect. So basically what that says is, if you're a blocked user, like you are denied access based on your IP address, normally the website will just show access denied, like a small text in white, and that's it. But what you can do is have a nicer web page that says, you know, you're not allowed to use the service. And so what you do is you redirect users that are blocked on IP to, you know, a site. So for example, I'm going to go, you know, I can do, for example, sample.org. Let's try that. Redirect. So when you're blocked, go to sample.org. And then I have in settings, I can put the allowed IP addresses. And what I'm going to do is I'm only going to allow, I'm only going to allow 1.2.3.4, for example. So this will make it so that I'm denied access to the service. So I'm going to run, and since I'm not coming from 1.2.3.4, when I, it says unauthorized. And yeah, well, so I won't debug this, but basically when set up correctly, this will redirect to this IP address, this page. So that's pretty much simple. Anyway, I don't want to make this video too long, but basically, this allows you to create static web pages on Mesh Central. You don't have to create another Apache web server. Another benefit of this is if you're using Let's Encrypt to, you know, as the website as your certificate, and Mesh Central is auto-renewing the certificate and so on, then it's very nice to have your static website co-located inside the same server as Mesh Central, because then Let's Encrypt certificate applies to both the static website and the Mesh Central site. Anyway, that was a hopefully short and useful video. Thank you very much. Have a great day.